The Jagdpanzer 38 was a German light tank destroyer in World War II. It was based on the Romanian Marshall tank destroyer and built on a widened and lengthened Panzer 38D chassis with modified suspension. The Jagdpanzer 38 was never really called Hatcher. The name Hatcher was a designation for a related prototype, the E-10. But because the Skoda factory confused the two names in its documentation, the name was made popular after the war. The Jagdpanzer 38 succeeded the Marder Dry and went in production from April 1944 until 1945. And 2,538 were produced. Because the Jagdpanzer 38 was cost effective, other variants were made. Variants like the Befehlswagen, the Flammenpanzer, the Bergpanzer, and two post-war vehicles called the ST-1 and the G-13. The first Jagdpanzer we are looking at is the one at Bovington, and we know its serial number and where it was made. We also know that it was captured in Belgium in 1945 and that was sent to England for trials and testing. The second Jagdpanzer is owned by the Bruce Crompton Collection. We don't know the precise serial number, but what we do know is where it was made and when it was knocked out. Because it was knocked out on April 13, 1945, in Cloppenburg, Germany, by an anti-tankkampf from the 7th Royal Hampshire Regiment. It was hit on the left side near the front, killing the driver. After the war, it was bulldozed into a bomb crater until it was discovered and recovered during roadworks in 1982. It was bought by a German collector and was restored. It was then sold to the Crompton Collection that restored it to running condition. It was probably restored with G-13 parts, because it shows some post-war additions. This Jagdpanzer is an odd looking one. It was captured in France in 1945, probably on the training grounds, where it was used as a Fahrschulepanzer. It was sent to Samur and somehow ended up in the Samur scrapyard. It was then sent to the Rex & Rod Chetman collection. Sadly, it's still in the same condition it was when it left Samur. This Jagdpanzer I really do enjoy seeing, because it has an odd but awesome camouflage. We don't know a lot about this one, only the serial number, where it was built and that it was sent to Kubinka for testing, where it still is today on display at the museum. This Jagdpanzer I don't enjoy seeing around a lot, just because of that god awful paint job. It just looked like something from Wilson Panzer. We do know a lot of history about this one, and that was found at the Skoda factory in Pilsen, and it was shipped to America for testing. It was then sent to the Aberdeen Profit Ground, where it was cut open and placed in display. It was restored in 2008 and sent to Fort Lee. During this restoration, traces of this weird camouflage was found under the old, and it was repainted in this experimental, extraordinary camouflage scheme. Historical accuracy or not, it's still ugly as sin. This Jagdpanzer was knocked out in Prague in May of 1945. It was shipped back to the factory by the Germans to be rebuilt, but it never returned to service. After war, it was sold to the Swiss Army and made into a G-13. After that, it ended up in a private collection in Germany. It was bought by the Australian Armour and Interior Museum and restored to a running wartime Jagdpanzer in the UK. This Jagdpanzer in Canada was possibly abandoned by its crew when the gun vehicle mechanism failed, Other crews sabotaged the gun on their own because they needed to abandon the tank for an unknown reason. After the war, it was sent to Canada for testing. After that, it ended up at Borden. This Jagdpanzer in the Thun Panzer Museum was sent to Switzerland after the war. There it was made into a G14, where it was later restored back to a World War II Jagdpanzer and placed in the Thun Panzer Museum. This Jagdpanzer was captured by tactical number 303. We know the Varkenstein number and where it was made. And that was bought by Sweden after the war. It was placed on trials and after that placed in the Panzer Museum at Axel. It was then sent to the Arsenal Tank Museum, where it's still on display, showing off its post-war additions. This Jagdpanzer was signed up at the German 73rd Infantry Division and was blown up and abandoned by its crew on 17 January of 1945 near Blondie, Poland. It was recovered from a river in Poland in 1999 or 1991 and placed at a museum in Warsaw. This Jagdpanzer probably belonged to the 82nd Infantry Division and was abandoned and blown up, and the barrel was booby-trapped by its crew. It was found in 2007 in Jurata, Poland, lying in the sea, 10 meters away from the shore. It was transported to the museum in, I don't even want to pronounce that, but it is in Brezny, where it was being restored, but restorations halted due to unknown reasons, and it is now being stored in an unknown car park. This Jagdpanzer with three other Jagdpanzers was captured by the Czechoslovakian rebels on 5th of May 1945 at the Skoda factory. After the main guns have been replaced by machine guns, these vehicles took place in the battle for the streets of Prague. After the war, it was stored and sent to the museum. The G14 or ST1 is a post-war production model made by Skoda for the Swiss Army in 1947. Not all vehicles were manufactured after the war, and in some cases vehicles and wartime spares were used and repurposed and sold to the Swiss. This next G14 was a gift to the Imperial War Museum by the Swiss Ministry of Defense in January 1981. It was modified to look like a Hatcher sometime in 2001. This Jagdpanzer G14 has no history. It is currently being restored in the UK after being salvaged from a firing range. This G14 came from the Royal Museum of Armed Forces and of Military History in Brussels, Belgium. It is now being restored at the Bastogne Barracks Museum, and new evidence shows that it was probably a wartime vehicle. This G14 has no recorded history. It was repainted a few years ago and placed inside the museum after being on display outside for a long time. I have some fond memories about this tank because I would go to see it in my summer vacation with my parents, and as a 10-year-old boy I would take pictures of it and climb on top of it, trying to do my first picture walk around. This is another G14 with no recorded history. It was placed next to the museum in the 80s as an eye catcher. This G14 has also no history, and it was also placed as an eye catcher next to the Casemat de Alschenbach in France. This G14 also has no recorded history. You can view it in the War Museum in Overloon, and it was restored to look like a wartime Hatcher. This G14 was formerly displayed at the Wehrtechniks Studiumsammlung Koblenz. It was restored to look like a wartime Jagdpanzer and is now stored at Meppen. This G14 was a gift from the Swiss Army to the Kampftruppenschulen 3 in 1971. It was restored to the running order in 1982 and is now on display at the Münster Panzer Museum. This amazing looking G14 has no recorded history, but it was restored to running order, and if you're lucky, you can see it in some reenactments in Poland. This G14 also has no recorded history. It was currently owned by the Museum de l'Ambrie collection in France. This nice looking G14 has no recorded history, but is on display in the Virginia Museum of Military Vehicles. The last G14 we are looking at was currently owned by the 1st Armored Division Museum in Baumholder, Germany. It was always on display with its gun jammed in full recoil. It was repainted at the old Ironside Museum, but the gun is still in full recoil position.